The camera feedback loop is a vital component to make the most of the Vidiot. You'll need a video camera, the Vidiot, a monitor for luma output, preferably a CRT, and some means to view or capture your final output. We're using an Ikigami VCM901 CRT monitor, a Sony DCR SR100 camcorder, and the Blackmagic Intensity Shuttle to preview and capture the final colorized video output. You can also view the final output on a second monitor, and record that monitor directly with another camera. To make the necessary connections, you'll need two composite video cables with male RCA connectors, as well as the accessory composite output cable for your video camera. Use one composite video cable to connect the video input on your monitor to the luma output on the rear of the Vidiot. Then connect the camera's composite output to the Vidiot's video input. Make sure to set the NTSC PAL slider above the video input jack to match your camera's hardware. Finally, use the second RCA cable to connect the Vidiot's colorizer output to the Intensity Shuttle's composite video input. To deliver external video to the Vidiot, you need only to connect the video output from your devices to your Vidiot's video input connection. We've been making good use of a cheap LG DVD player and a Dreamcast here in our studio. If you're not getting any feedback when you finish connecting and powering on your system, it could be due to either your equipment or the Vidiot. First, check your monitor and camera using alternative equipment. You can even feed your camera directly into the monitor. If you get a video image, both your monitor and camera are functioning fine. If you're still not getting video, it's likely due to settings on the Vidiot. The camera feedback loop in the Vidiot relies on the luma circuit, which is controlled by the three large knobs on the left of the instrument. Brightness and contrast may need to be adjusted or have their polarity switches flip before you'll see luma patterns emerge on the monitor. As a last-ditch effort, try patching noise output to the luma brightness input. It helped kickstart our feedback loop in earlier trials. In some rare cases, the Vidiot shipped with a misconfigured internal cable. If you feel you've got all the equipment, connections, and settings otherwise correct, this could be your problem. Please refer to the first video on our channel, Unbooking the Vidiot, in order to rectify this problem. The first step in optimizing your feedback loop is camera setup. The framing of your monitor within the camera makes a big difference. Once you establish a feedback pattern, which we'll address in a moment, you can change your camera's distance to the monitor and change the zoom and focus . As you probably noticed, motion itself induces trail effects in the feedback loop. The camera feedback loop is potent not only for its random amplification and modification of the luma signal, but also for the opportunity to physically modify and mask the image by inserting objects between the camera and CRT. You can shine a flashlight on the television or into the camera to introduce new luma data, but most of it will dissipate quickly once the source is removed. You can also place objects in the frame and use their silhouettes to key some very interesting shapes, which themselves influence the trailing and expanding feedback data. While the camera feedback loop is an excellent source of random synthesis, the Vidiot can also be used to touch up traditional media. By connecting our Dreamcast to the video input on the back of the Vidiot, we can colorize, key, and overlay the original content to add subtle new tones, generate abstract inspiration, or maybe just make mats for motion graphics. Many DVD players include playback from USB thumb drives, allowing you to treat your own content without additional hardware. Just make sure you encode your videos at standard definition, and as always, match your Vidiot's NTSC PAL switch to match the region of the source device. Following this tutorial, you should now have a functioning camera feedback loop. You can vary the feedback loop by patching device-generated pattern outputs into lumicide inputs, and then continuing to vary the brightness, contrast, and detail CV and control values. Adding keying or thresholding by adjusting either the luma negative or solarized sliders to the key position, and adjust the key 1 knob to set your threshold value. You can also introduce color variation using the colorizer. We'll go into more depth on pattern control and colorization in our upcoming tutorials.